Hello students, last time we have studied the type of catalysis, homogeneous catalysis and heterogeneous catalysis. So in homogeneous catalysis, physical state of all reactants and products, catalysts are same, and in heterogeneous catalysis, physical states of reactants and catalysts are different, called as heterogeneous catalysis. With example, last time we have studied. Also, we have studied the mechanism of heterogeneous catalysis. In heterogeneous catalysis, first of all, diffusion of reactant's molecule takes place at the surface of catalyst, that is the adsorbent, and after that the reactant molecule get adsorbed on the surface of catalyst, then there is a reaction between the reactant molecule catalyst to produce an intermediate, and product is formed and desorption of the product takes place. These points we have studied last time. Today we have to study important features of solid catalysis or catalyst, that is selectivity of catalyst, means catalytic selectivity or activity, then catalytic selectivity, and we have to study safe selective catalysis by the zeolites. These three points in detail we have to study. So here see, catalytic activity in a chemical reaction depends upon the activity of catalyst. Catalyst depends on the adsorption of reactants on catalyst. That is, in chemisorption, if reactants are get strongly adsorbed on catalyst as well as if large amount of reactant get adsorbed on the surface of catalyst, then that catalyst is active, or its activity is what, that is the more. म्हणजे जर जास्त प्रमाणामध्ये रिएक्टंट मॉलिक्यूल कॅटलिस्ट वर ऍब्सॉर्ब होत असतील स्ट्रॉंगली, देन दॅट इज नथिंग बट द ऍक्टिव्ह कॅटलिस्ट, ऑर द ऍक्टिव्हिटी ऑफ कॅटलिस्ट इज मोर. अँड देअर शुड बी नो स्ट्रॉंग बॉन्ड बिटवीन the catalyst and reactant due to which they are immobilized on their surface. म्हणजे त्यांच्यातला बॉन्ड एवढा स्ट्रॉंग नको की त्या सर्फेस वर ते इमोबिलाइज होतील. And if they are immobilized, then there will be no reaction takes place. So bond should be strong, but not so strong, due to which reactants are immobilized and activity should be what that is the more, and if activity is more when they are strongly adsorbed on their surface, it is found that D block elements, that is the transition elements, D block elements like the iron, vanadium, chromium provides the larger surface area and their catalytic activity is more, and they adsorb, the element or gases like what that is the oxygen, acetylene, ethylene, carbon monoxide, as well as what that is the carbon dioxide, then nitrogen. So they are very active on the surface of this iron, vanadium or chromium. So their activity is more. As well as the metal like magnesium and lithium. Absorbs oxygen gas strongly on their surface. Means their catalytic activity is more. That is nothing but the catalytic activity. So catalytic activity means when catalyst, it depends upon the adsorption of reactant molecule on the surface of catalyst. If the reactant molecule on the surface of catalyst are strongly adsorbed, then their activity is more. And also strong chemical bond is formed in case of chemisorption. But chemical bond formed between the reactant molecule and catalyst not so strong, due to which the reactant molecule becomes immobilized. And therefore here, not so strong. D block elements like iron, vanadium, chromium adsorb the gases like oxygen, acetylene, ethylene, carbon dioxide, nitrogen on more extent or in more extent. They are strongly adsorbed on its surface, as well as magnesium and lithium adsorb the oxygen gas strongly on it. Now the second one point which we have to study, it is the catalytic selectivity. So catalytic selectivity in a chemical reaction, the product form, depends on, catalyst used in that reaction. For the same chemical reaction, if we change the catalyst, आपण जर एकाच chemical reaction मध्ये म्हणजे reactant तेच आहे, only if we change the catalyst, the product obtained are different. Product is different. Therefore, formation of product in a chemical reaction depends upon the selectivity of catalyst. Which catalyst is selected in that chemical reaction? यानी क्या वो chemical reaction में हमें कौन सा, हमने कौन सा catalyst select किया है, कौन सा catalyst use किया है? That depends, means product formation depends on the selectivity of catalyst. Some examples here we have to study in it. That is nothing but the ethylene when treated. Here see first one example, C2H4 gas when reacts with oxygen gas in the presence of palladium and alumina as catalyst on heating this mixture, in this reaction there is formation of acetaldehyde is obtained. Acetaldehyde is formed. Here, there is formation of acetaldehyde in gaseous state. That is, acetaldehyde is obtained. Balance equation by taking here 2 and here also 2. So, acetaldehyde is obtained. But if in the same reaction, if we use different catalyst, अगर हमने इस रिएक्शन में कैटलिस्ट अगर डिफरेंट यूज किया अलग यूज किया तो प्रोडक्ट फॉर्म इज आल्सो डिफरेंट. यू सी दैट केमिकल रिएक्शन इन विच वी हैव टू यूज हियर ट्वाइस ऑफ C2H4 प्लस O2 गैस. देन दिस रिएक्शन इफ टेक्स प्लेस इन द प्रेजेंस ऑफ सिल्वर एंड एल्यूमिना एज कैटलिस्ट then the product obtained is different, that is C2H5O, H4O, that is ethylene oxide is obtained, ethylene oxide is formed. There is formation of the ethylene oxide in gaseous state, so here the product is changed. When the catalyst in that chemical reaction is changed, therefore, formation of product depends upon the selection of catalyst or catalyst used in that chemical reaction. If different, the product obtained also different. So, that is nothing but the catalytic selectivity. Catalytic selectivity in that chemical reaction. Here see another one example. Reaction of the hydrogen gas and carbon monoxide. You see here H2 plus CO. Okay, here it is gas. This is also gas. If this reaction is take place in the presence of nickel as catalyst, then the product obtained is methane and oxygen gas as a byproduct. Product obtained is methane and oxygen gas as what, that is the byproduct obtained in this reaction. In this reaction, methane and the here there is formation of H2O. When nickel, hydrogen gas and carbon monoxide gas, if treated in the presence of nickel as catalyst, then methane is obtained and water is formed. This equation balance by taking here 3. Now second reaction same, H2 plus CO, here hydrogen gas plus carbon monoxide gas. If this reaction takes place in the presence of copper, zinc and the chromium oxide, then in this reaction there is formation of methanol in gaseous state. So here due to change in catalyst, there is change in the product. Reactants are same, but if different catalyst is used in the same chemical reaction, then there is change in the product. So, the formation of product in a same chemical reaction depends upon what, that is the selection of catalyst. It depends upon the selection of catalyst. Here zinc and chromium oxide, Er2O3. That is nothing but the second one point. Here third point, we have to study same selective catalysis by zeolite. Zeolites are the substances obtained in the nature also, that is in earth crust, that is in rock. So zeolites are aluminosilicate with three-dimensional network of silicate. जो भी rock होता है, soil होती है, उसमें silicate होते हैं. So zeolites are aluminosilicate with three-dimensional network of silicate. In this network of silicate, some silicon atoms, if replaced or substituted by aluminium, some silicon atoms, if replaced by the aluminium, They form aluminium oxygen silicon framework. Network ka conversion yaha is aluminium oxygen silicon framework mein convert ho jata hai. Forms microporous structure, porous structure form hota hai isme. And therefore due to this porous nature, zeolites are used in the purification of water. It rods are used, and due to that they filter the water and impurities can be removed. So they forms the microporous structure. Reaction in zeolite depends upon the size and shape of that reactants and what that is the product, and also pores and cavities in zeolite. Size of the reactant molecule, size of the product molecule, as it is microporous, therefore pores in that zeolite and what that is the cavities in zeolite, these all things decide the reactions in zeolite. Okay? And in that microporous, what happens? The reactant molecule get absorbed and there is formation of product. So shape selective catalysis, zeolites are the best shape selective catalysis. It should be remembered that in petroleum industry, ZSMS, this is the name of zeolite which is used in petroleum industry, in which the alcohol directly converted into gasoline, that is the petrol. Or in this case, there is formation of the mixture of hydrocarbons. There is formation of the mixture of hydrocarbons. So that is nothing but the shape selective catalysis by the zeolite. And this is about the catalysis. That is the important features of solid catalysis. And now we have to start the second one. Topic included in it, that is nothing but the colloids. That is nothing but the colloids. So here see, colloids. In it what we have to study? What are the colloids? Different types of colloidal solutions. Name of that different types of colloidal solutions and examples also we have to study. In this what that is the examples and types you have to remember, they are asking exam. Now here see, colloids or colloidal solution. See, the colloids. Here, it should be remembered and noted that in our daily life, we are using many types of colloidal solutions. For example, the colloidal solutions, most of our food are in the form of colloids. In the form of colloids. Colloids. For example, that is the roti, also the vegetables, then the pudding, then what that is the butter, jam, also jelly, all they are in colloidal state, Some substances which we are using in our daily life, that is the toothpaste, then boot polish, they are in colloidal state, they are colloidal solutions. Most of the medicines also in colloidal state or colloidal form. So what is this colloidal form, what is the colloidal state and what is the colloidal solutions? That first of all we have to study. Here point to be remembered that there are mainly three type of substances. And these three type of substances are what that is the true solutions in which the size of particle is 0.1 to 2 nanometer, 0.1 to 2 nanometer, then colloidal solutions, colloids or colloidal solutions, 2 to 500 nanometer size of particles, size of particles in this solution, 2 to 500 nanometer. And third type of solutions are the suspensions, suspensions where size is greater than 500 nanometer. So they are larger size. The particles present in suspension, solute particles present in suspensions are larger in size. Okay. True solutions are clear and transparent. True solutions are clear and transparent. For example, if we add common salt, sodium chloride in water, then that solution is clear and transparent. We can't find what is added in it or it is of which solution. If we add sugar in water, then that solution also clear and transparent. We can't find what is the substance present in that solution. Urea solution also, alcohol in water, all these are examples of true solution. Because the size of particle is very small, it cannot be detected under the ultra microscope also. So they are true solution. Magar colloidal solution mein particle, solute particle ki size jyada badi hai. और ये ज्यादा बड़ी होने के कारण से दे आर नॉट क्लियर एंड ट्रांसपेरेंट, दे आर टर्बिड. कोलाइडल सॉल्यूशंस, कोलाइडल सॉल्यूशंस, कोलाइडल सॉल्यूशंस आर नॉट क्लियर एंड ट्रांसपेरेंट, ट्रांसपेरेंट, दे आर व्हाट दैट इज द टर्बिड. एज वेल एज these solutions, colloidal solutions passes through ordinary filter paper slowly, while true solutions passes, diffuses fastly through the ordinary filter paper. यानि कि ordinary filter paper के ऊपर अगर हमने true solution pour किया, डाला, तो ये बहुत fast उसमें से pass होता है. मगर ये colloidal solutions अगर उसके ऊपर add kiya, that diffuses slowly through the normal or ordinary filter paper. So for example gum solution, then what, that is the starch solution also, starch solution. So they are turbid, not clear, and they cannot diffuses fastly. They diffuses all through ordinary filter paper slowly. So that is nothing but the colloidal solution. And what is about the suspension? Size of the solute particle is larger. For example, silica added in water, it settled down at the bottom and we can find out easily that it contains the silica. यानी कि पानी में अगर रेती हम add कर दें, so that is the suspension. That is the suspension. It is clearly visible that it contains the silica in this way. Now see the next one point, that is colloidal solutions consist of two phases. जैसे कि true solution में दो phases होते हैं, कौन सी, solute and solvent. तो colloidal solution में भी दो phases हैं. That is the dispersed phase. This dispersed phase is a substance. It is a substance which is dispersed in another substance. So that is nothing but the dispersed phase. यानी कि ये ऐसा सब्सटेंस है कि जो दूसरे सब्सटेंस में डिस्पर्स होता है, जैसे कि सॉल्यूशन, ट्रू सॉल्यूशन में सोलूट सॉल्वेंट में डिजॉल्व होता है, तो यहाँ ये सोलूट दैट इज द डिस्पर्स फेज विच इज डिस्पर्स्ड इन अनदर सब्सटेंस, यानी कि ये सब्सटेंस क्वांटिटेटिवली इट इज लेस और ये दूसरे सब्सटेंस में ऐसा डिस्पर्स होता है, स्प्रेड होता है, सो दैट इज द डिस्पर्स फेज. एंड सेकंड वन फेज इज डिस्पर्शन मीडियम, इट इज डिस्पर्शन मीडियम. So what is dispersion medium? It is the substance in which colloidal solution is prepared. That is nothing but the dispersion medium, or in which another substance is dispersed. और इसमें दूसरा सब्सटेंस डिस्पर्स होता है, सो दैट इज नथिंग बट द डिस्पर्शन मीडियम. या मीडियम यानी क्या? सॉल्वेंट. एंड डिस्पर्स फेज यानी क्या? सोलूट. सो दैट इज नथिंग बट द टू फेजेस प्रेजेंट इन कोलाइडल सॉल्यूशंस, दैट इज डिस्पर्स फेज एंड डिस्पर्शन मीडियम. डिस्पर्स फेज यानी क्या? सब्सटेंस वो दूसरे सब्सटेंस में स्प्रेड होता है, डिस्पर्स होता है यूनिफॉर्मली. और ये मीडियम यानी क्या? उसमें हम वो कोलाइडल सॉल्यूशन प्रिपेयर करते हैं और इस सब्सटेंस में दूसरा सब्सटेंस डिस्पर्स होता है, सो दैट इज नथिंग बट द डिस्पर्शन मीडियम. फॉर एग्जांपल यू टेक एग्जांपल ऑफ द गम और स्टार्च सॉल्यूशन. गम और स्टार्च सॉल्यूशन, यहां गम पार्टिकल्स और स्टार्च पार्टिकल्स इज dispersed phase, it is dispersed phase. And water में हम इसे अगर prepare करते हैं तो it is dispersion medium. So this is introductory point about the colloids. In the next lecture we will study about different types of colloids on the basis of physical state of the dispersed phase and dispersion medium.